my handy bunnies, and welcome back to a new video. Hopefully you guys are doing amazing. I know I haven't been on here for a while. I think it's been like 3 weeks since I last posted, but I'm here with a new video. It's kind of hard to come back with everything that's going on in the world. It just really makes it really hard to focus on this type of thing when there's more important things going on, but I really wanted to come by and film a video for you guys. It's gonna be a collective summer thrift haul. It's gonna be my last summer haul, so before we start going into fall, I want to show you guys the last few pieces that I recently picked up from the thrift store. If you guys didn't know, secondhand shopping is very eco-friendly. It helps the environment so much because you're keeping these pieces, these clothing pieces or bags or shoes or whatever it may be, from hitting the landfill and just sitting there. Clothes doesn't really go away, it just sits there and creates more waste. So if you can, please try to thrift, donate your clothing. Don't just throw it out in the trash. Try to like sell it or donate it. Let's just get started because I do have a whole bunch of things to show you. I have some accessories, home decor, clothing, and I suggest you guys getting a drink or some snacks because I have lots to show you. And this is not from one place or one time. It is gonna be a collective haul, so from different thrift stores, different times. I've been thrifting a lot, and that's because I love thrifting. I think it's really exciting. I love to hunt for these little treasures, and also because I recently decluttered a lot of my clothing. I did a video on it, but before that, I decluttered even more, and I only have a little bit of clothes, so I'm kind of like rebuilding my wardrobe, and I've been having a lot of fun. So let's just get started. I think I'm gonna start with home decor just to get that out of the way. I've been finding a lot of cute things at the thrift store. This little, I don't know what this is, like a little disc. I found this and I was like, yes, I can use this to put it up on my wall. I was initially thinking of doing a basket wall on the wall behind me right there, but I don't think I am. I think I'm gonna do something with my plants instead, maybe like a shelf or something around the lines for plants. So I'm not gonna hang it on the wall, but I did really love this. It's a wicker, just plate. I don't know what these are called, but this was only $1.99 and I found this at Goodwill. The other thing that I found at Goodwill, I was so excited because it's a box. It's like a very vintagey box. Let me back up a little bit so you guys can see what it looks like, but it's just a very vintage looking type of box. It has some little handles and I absolutely loved it when I first saw it. I was like, yes, this is exactly what I'm looking for my beauty room. It is very old. It's kind of broken and cracked in some areas, but I didn't care because it just adds character to the piece. I got this for $4, so $3.99 at Goodwill. If you watched my room makeover video, I will link it in the cards if you guys want to check it out. I did use this as a little, I used it like this, and I had a little plant in here. It was a little cactus. I took it out because the cactus needs more sunlight, so I put it on my windowsill instead. But my whole vision with this box was to put a plant in there, just kind of use it as a little planter. That's exactly how I'm using it now. I have a little figgy in there. I'll kind of like do a cutaway so you guys can see what it looks like now. The next thing that I picked up from Goodwill are a lot of different glasswares like this. So I got these because I really wanted to start propagating some of my plants in water. So I picked a whole bunch of different sizes and shapes, and this is the only one that I haven't used, but I'm gonna show you guys all of the ones that I have along the windowsill so you guys can see what they look like. They're very unique and very cute. Let me show you guys this one. This one over here is super cute, and everything that I got was around $1, $2 to $3, and I think this was $3 because it's a little bigger. But I absolutely love propagating in glass jars or, you know, glassware like this, and you can always find really cute ones at the thrift store. You don't have to buy expensive ones. I went to a very cute plant shop and they were selling the cutting plus the glass in different shapes and sizes, and they were like $30. $30. I'm like, no, I don't think so. I can do this by myself. Let me show you guys this one as well, because this one is very interesting and very unique. It kind of just looks like a very tiny jar. I don't know if you guys can see that. It is so cute. I have my spider plant propagating in here, and you can see like the roots. I love propagating in water because you can see the roots forming, and it's very interesting. Let's move on to accessories. I have some belts and some handbags and some shoes. So let's start with the belts. I have been getting really lucky at the thrift store finding really cute belts that actually fit me. I find cute ones all the time, but they're either super tiny or really, really big. But this one over here is a brown one. And I really wanted to get this one because of the detail of the buckle right here. This one I did find at Goodwill, and this was $5.99, which I thought was kind of expensive for a belt, like a used belt. But I still went ahead and got it because I don't have a brown belt. This next one is a braided belt, and it's a full leather belt. These are all full leather, just FYI. But yeah, I found this one at Salvation Army. I already wore this with a beige t-shirt dress just to cinch it at the waist, and I absolutely love it. So I'm really glad that I found this. This was, I think, $3, but I got it half off because they were doing half off on all of the clothing and accessories. I found a neutral snake print belt. This is also fake. It's not a real snake. This beaded shell bag. It's a vintagey type of bag. I actually looked up the brand. It's called Carla Marchi. And it sounds like, from what I read, it's a vintage type of bag, and I absolutely love it. I got it for $7.99. at Goodwill, and I was beyond the moon when I saw this. I'm like, yes, you're coming home with me because you're super freaking cute. So this one is a two-tone bag, and it is very old as well. You can even tell like the logo. It's from the brand Liz Claiborne, and the thing right here is so old. I have been looking for a two-tone type of purse like this one. The Dooney, it's a Dooney and Burke. Is that how you pronounce it? Anyways, those type of bags are very popular right now and very trendy. I love this little bag. I think it's super cute. It's very neutral. I can wear it with so many different outfits. I got this one for only $5.99. So I found, I don't even want to show you guys these because they're really dirty and disgusting because I've been wearing them nonstop. But this is what they look like. These were brand new. My Goodwill has been receiving a lot of new shoes. I got them for $9.99, and at first I saw them and I'm like, oh, these are so cute and these are very trendy, and I've been wanting a pair of these for a while. And I did see one at Marshall's, but they were from Steve Madden. They were $39, which is 40 bucks. And I was like, okay, no, I'm not gonna spend 40 bucks just on sandals. But I am so glad that I found these. It does have my footprint now. But before, when I first bought them, it didn't have all that. Okay, next up, I found a pair of black strappy kitten heel shoes. And these are very trendy. I was so excited when I found these because I'm like, yes! I've been looking for something like this in a black or a beige, and I finally found the black ones. But unfortunately, they don't fit. They're actually very narrow. I have more of a wider foot. So they do fit like this way. They just don't fit like the width part. But I got this because nobody has ever worn this. Look at the sole. Brand new. If you guys are interested in this pair, I'm also gonna put this up for sale. And let me tell you guys right now, so this, you can tell that it's never been worn. Everything, like the sole, the straps, are in very mint condition. But the actual part down here, it's falling apart. You can tell that it's very, very old, and the material is just kind of like disintegrating. I didn't even notice until I came home because, like I said, they look brand new. But when I put my foot in this one, I don't know if you guys can see, it kind of just took off a little bit of the lining. Thing started to peel. So that is the only thing wrong with these shoes. But I think it's a very easy fix. All you have to do is get one of those like jelly things that you put right here, and then another one over here, or you can take them to get fixed and have them put a different lining in here. But I think these are super cute. I wish they fit me because I would definitely keep them. These are very trendy. Sara has a pair very similar to these for like almost $100. Hopefully my camera doesn't start overheating. But anyways, let's move on to some denim shorts. So these are originally men's jeans that I turned into shorts. Like my denim shorts, my cutoff shorts are all men's jeans from the thrift store. I just gave up on women's shorts because women's denim shorts just never fit me right. They're always just something wrong with them. And right now they're always super short. Like, I don't want to be showing my nalgas to everybody, so I want something a little bit longer, and for some reason they don't exist. So I've been doing a lot of my own DIY denim cutoff shorts, and I am going to be doing a video. I know it's one of my most requested videos to do whenever I talk about it on Instagram. This one is from The Gap originally, and it's the boot fit in the size 32. That is usually what I go for, either 30 or 32. That's just what fits me. I fluctuate. I like gain weight and lose weight very often, so 30 to 32 is what fits me, sometimes even a 34, so it just depends. What I love about this pair is the wash. It's more like a medium wash. You can see the little what is this little imprint of the wallet? I guess the guy who wore this wore their wallet in the back pocket. I actually have some shorts that have like the imprint of the wallet in the front, which is really funny. But anyways, my second pair, which is my second favorite pair of shorts, this is from the brand Paper Denim and Cloth. I think it was out of the Closet thrift store, and I just had to pick it up. Even though it is a size 34, I came home and it actually does fit very loose. I really love like the baggy look that this short, this pair of shorts give me. My last pair of shorts, I really messed them up and they don't even fit me anymore. When I bought them, I did fit them. They were kind of like fitted, but now they're like super tight. They even give me like a muffin top. This is a size 30, so I think that's why. But this is from the brand Goodfellow & Co., which I think is from Target. It's super cute. I love the wash, but I messed up like the cutting. I cut it too short, and yeah, I mean, it's still cute. I think I'm just either gonna redonate this. Found this little nightgown, like a little night slip dress, and it's more like lingerie. Me and my wife call it lingerie, but it's lingerie. But you're not even gonna believe, this is a vintage piece. It's like 1960s, 1970s, and I just couldn't believe it. I got it because it just looks so effing cute. It's very feminine and very sexy. But when I looked up the brand, I realized that it was a vintage piece, and I just couldn't believe it. I got this for $5. Moving on to a top, I found this at Goodwill just recently, and this one does have a big like rip in the front, but I can easily fix that just by sewing it together. But I love the like boho-ness vibes from this top. It's very cute. It's 100% cotton from The Gap, extra small. And I just love the crocheting, and it's just a really cute top, and I can definitely use this for spring, summer, and even fall. So this was $6. My last top is a peasant long sleeve top, and this is from the brand Lucky Brand in a size small. These tops are very expensive. I used to love Lucky Brand so much, but I would always wait for like a sale because their tops range from like $50 to like $200, and I got this for $6. I think $6.49 or $6.99, something like that. But super cute. I did already wear this, and I'm gonna show you guys what I styled it with. I actually wore it with those denim shorts that I absolutely love, my favorite ones, the very first ones I show you guys. I paired it with those shorts, some wedges, and then my two-tone thrifted bag, and I thought it was like the cutest outfit ever. This next piece I found at Goodwill, and this was $8.49, and this is a romper. Now, when it comes to rompers, I never pick them up because they never fit right. That rompers just don't fit all that great for my body, and I saw this and I thought it was a dress, but I still took it with me into the fitting room. And that's one of my tips when it comes to thrifting. Even if you don't think it's gonna fit you, even if you think it's not gonna look that great on you or whatever, still try it on, because you might be surprised, just like I was with this piece. I tried it on and I'm like, it's not gonna fit all that great. It's gonna fit very awkward, too short. And I'm gonna try to wear it before summer ends. If not, I can always wear it next summer. I found these kimchi blue tube top dresses, and I found two of them, one in a purple and then the other one's a blue, and they both have different patterns. The first one I found was this purple one, and I'm like, this is so cute. I don't have purple in my wardrobe, and I just love these little tube top, like midi slash maxi dresses. It depends how tall you are. This to me is more like a maxi dress, but it does hit me like where my ankle is at. So I thought it was a great length, because sometimes when I wear maxi dresses, they're super, super like long, that they drag, or I have to wear heels or wedges so that they don't drag. But this is a really great length, and I bought two because one of them I am gonna try to sell because I think it's super cute, and some of you guys always say that I find cute things. So this way I can shop for you guys. The purple one I did already wear with a black hat, a black purse, and some black sandals, and I thought it was super cute. It kind of gave me that like relaxed boho vibes, and you guys know that's what I'm about. But yeah, these are from Kimchi Blue. One of them is, the purple one is a size small, medium, and the blue one is a size large, but they fit very, very alike. They're the same cut, same style, just different color and different pattern. This next dress is really out there in color. It's very bright, and I wasn't gonna get it, but I thought it would be cute for like vacation, maybe at the beach or like dinner. It is more like a Hawaiian type of dress, like, you know, like a vacay type of dress. I thought it was super cute. It's just a long maxi dress, and I love the color and the fact that it has a little bit of yellow in it. This is a long maxi dress, and I love that it's not super long, so it fits my very short body. I'm only 5'2", so I always have to be careful with when I buy maxi dresses because they're just so long. Last but not least, I have this really feminine, girly type of skirt. I found this at Crossroads. I haven't washed this one, that's why I still have the tag. But this one was $22.50, and it's in a size large. At first I'm like, wow, $22 for a skirt is kind of like paying for a regular skirt if I were to buy it new. But I just went ahead and got it because I thought it was really cute. I love the crisscross in the front. It has a little bit of eyelid material, like little ruffles, kind of like this shirt that I'm wearing right now. It has a little bit of like ruffle. When I came home, I decided to look this brand up because I've never heard of it. It's called Lovers and Friends, and oh my god, they are so expensive. Their skirts, I think they have one just like this right now on their website, just in a different color. So expensive. I'm gonna put it on the screen so you guys can see it. I think it's around $100 or maybe even more. And yes, we are finally done. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this collective haul. Let me know in the comments if you guys prefer this type of setting where I collect a whole bunch of thrifted items and then show it to you guys in a video, or do you guys prefer me doing the come thrift with me vlog style, and then at the end I showed you guys what I picked up. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did, give it a huge thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you guys haven't done so. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys on my next one. Bye guys.